Good morning, KG3. How are you today? Now we are going to do page 276, which is how to take apart 6 and 7. If we have 6 objects, how can we take them apart and put them into 2 different groups? If we take 3 and put them in the first group, we can put another 3 in the second. And all together make 6. So we can take apart 6 with 3 and 3. We circle the groups, then write the number. Here it's already done, so we trace it. Let's move to 7. How can we make 7? We can make 7 with different ways. Now, how can we take apart 7? Look. We make 7 if we put together 5 and 2. But we can take apart 7, we can divide those 7 or put away 2 here. And for example, if we chose 1, 2, we take 2. And how many are left? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 2 and 5 make 7. Here, this example is done with 5 and 2. So we can put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in the first group and 1, 2 in the second. Now here we have 7 as well. We have 7 objects. We want to take them apart and put them into 2 different groups. How can we do that? We circle objects in the first group, then we put a certain number of objects in the second. How can we do them? It's for you to tell me how can we do it. Now here, 6 and 7, this page follow the same directions. We have to count the objects, circle the objects to show a way to take apart 6 and 7. Now we have to do page 278. Look, we have number of squares, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we write 6 here. They told us take apart first 2. So if we take 2 apart, how many are left? 1, 2, 3, 4. So we write 4 here. Now here, let's count the red cubes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we write 7 at the top. They also asked us to take apart 2. So we take apart 2, and now how many are left? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5. Look. Here, 2 and 4 make 6. But at the bottom here, 2 and 5 make 7. Can you see the difference?